Welcome to the Math Planet, your fast math guide. Hello everyone, I'm Ruki. Today I will show you how to subtract tens and ones on a 100 chart. So let's get started. Hi, my name is Ruki. Today I will show you how to use a 100 chart to subtract. First of all, let's understand the concept behind using a 100 chart. If you select any column from the 100 chart, you will notice that as you go up, you subtract tens, and as you go down the column, you add tens. Also, if you select any row from the 100 chart, you will notice that as you go to the left, you subtract ones, and as you go to the right, you add ones. Since today we're concerned about subtraction, so I will only move in two directions, up and to the left. So to subtract using a 100 chart, I will move up to subtract the tens and move to the left to subtract ones. To find the answer of this subtraction equation, whole minus part equals what? I will start at the whole, which is the first number in the subtraction equation, and then I will subtract the tens of the part by moving up and subtract the ones of the part by moving to the left, and the destination point will be the difference, which is the answer for the subtraction equation. Let's apply what we learned on this example. 65 minus 34. The start point is 65. Then I'll subtract 3 tens by moving up and subtract 4 ones by moving to the left, and the destination will be the answer. Here's the 100 chart. My start point is 65 and here am I at 65. And then I'll move 3 steps up and 4 steps to the left. 1, 2, 3 steps up and then 1, 2, 3, 4 steps to the left. Destination point is 31, which is the difference. Another example is 43 minus 28. My start point is 43, then I'll subtract 2 tens by moving up, and then I'll subtract 8 ones by moving to the left, and the answer will be at the destination point. Let's apply it on the 100 chart. The start point is 43, and then I'll move 2 steps up and 8 steps to the left. Here are 1, 2 steps up, and here are 1, 2 steps to the left. I need to move 6 more steps to the left, but there are no numbers before, so I need to move to the previous row to continue. So before 21 is 20, so I will go to 20, and then 19, 18, 17, 16, and 15. And the destination point will be at number 15, which is the difference. Finally, we will find the difference between 54 and 7. My start point is at 54, and then the 7 has no tens, so I will subtract 0 tens or no tens. Then I will subtract 7 ones by moving to the left of the chart, and the difference will be at the destination point. Here's the chart again. Start point is 54, then I will move only 7 steps to the left. Here are 1, 2, 3 steps, then I need to move to the previous row as we learned before. So I will go to 50, 49, 48 and 47, which is the destination point and the answer to this equation. To sum up what we learned for today, we learned how to subtract using a 100 chart. To subtract tens, you need to move up the chart. To subtract ones, you need to move to the left of the chart. And remember, if you reach the beginning of the row, you need to go to the end of the previous row to continue subtracting. We're done for today's lesson. Thank you for watching. Hope you liked the video. Please subscribe for more videos. See you later. Bye.